My name is Chloe, and today I'll be showing you how to use layer blend modes in your art. Just as a disclaimer, I'll only be covering the blend modes available in Clip Studio Paint, which should cover 90% of the blend modes in other programs. I'll link the blend mode user guides for other common programs in the description below. Also, I won't be explaining the formulas behind each blend mode. I don't really think it's that helpful in processing a digital illustration. The most important thing is that you know what they do to your picture. If you're new to digital art, layer blend modes might be kind of confusing. There's a lot of different options, and you might not really know what they do or how to use them. If you're anything like how I was when I first started drawing, you probably just ignored them altogether and thought it was too advanced for you. I'm gonna show you that they're not as hard as you think, and how they can be useful to you. You might be wondering, what are blend modes? Blend modes are a layer setting that determines how a layer blends with the layers beneath it. The default setting, or normal, lets the top layer cover up the layers beneath it. Other blend modes can create different effects. Blend modes are non-destructive, meaning that they don't permanently change the existing pixels on your canvas. So you can add as many blend modes as your heart desires and then turn them all off if you wanted to. They're a quick, easy, and effective way to add tints, lighting effects, and more vibrant or cohesive colors to your drawing. Really quickly, there's going to be three colors I'll talk about. The blend color, the base color, and the result color. The blend color is just the color of the layer with the blend mode, and the base color is the color underneath it. The result color is what you get from combining them. The most common blend modes are multiply, screen, and overlay. I'll explain the rest later. Multiply is the one you want to learn the most. Multiply, as the name suggests, multiplies the blend color with the base color. It will always make a darker result color, which makes it perfect for shading. Let's look at this for shading skin. I have the flat colors of my drawing on separate layers to make it easy to change them. I'll create a layer above the skin layer, set the blend mode to multiply, and turn clipping mask on. Now I'll select the grayish-reddish color in the color picker and draw in the shadows. The blend color darkens the base color seamlessly. No matter what color I change the skin to, the shadows will always be darker. Here's what the drawing shadows look like with the blend mode set to normal versus multiply. Multiplying with black will always produce black, and white will leave the base color unchanged. So you can use this as a very quick way to turn a black and white line drawing into a line art or texture. You can experiment with this to add noise or mood lighting to your pieces as well. Mastering multiply should be your main takeaway from this video. Next is screen. Screen is basically the opposite of multiply. It makes your base color lighter with the blend color. I'll use this to add highlights to the hair in this picture. I'm using bright cyan and magenta to give the highlights a tint. See how it lightens the base color, but still blends it with the blend color? Here's what it looks like on normal versus screen. White will always make white, and black will leave the illustration beneath unchanged. You can also try using this to add a snow or rain texture to your drawing. Now for overlay. Overlay is the combination of both multiply and screen. Using overlay makes light areas lighter and dark areas darker. The effect it gives is like a tinted, contrast-boosted version of the original colors. When used sparingly, this blend mode is many artists' cheat code for creating cohesive colors, myself included. Depending on your preference, you can use a light opacity overlay to bring your colors closer together while increasing the contrast in your painting. Using the color of the skin or eyes in your painting will balance the rest of the colors and draw focus to that color. However, you can use a color you like to tint the painting and give it an overall mood or feeling, kind of like glazing in oil painting. I like to use pink and purple overlays as I draw a lot of anime girls that I want to look pastel and cute. For the rest of the blend modes, I'll divide them into groups, as many of them achieve very similar effects. Conveniently, Clip Studio Paint groups them really closely together. I view the blend modes in four different categories: darkening, lightening, tinting, and functional. To avoid boring you, I won't go too far into detail about each individual one, but instead show you what each one does while I talk about the category, then show you what I use some of the specific blend modes for. Darkening blend modes include darken, darker color, multiply, color burn, and linear burn. As you learned with multiply, these modes darken the base colors by some measure of the blend colors, which makes them best suited for shading, mood lighting, and contrast adjustment. Color burn at 15% adds a subtle boost in the vibrancy of the overall piece. I like to use this when I feel my colors are looking a little flat. Linear burn is much stronger, and I use it for nighttime or dim-lit scenes. Lightning blend modes include Lighten, Lighter Color, Screen, Color Dodge, Glow Dodge, Add, and Add Glow. Lightning blend modes are good for anything that needs more lighting. Lighten is perfect for bounce lights, or the lights that reflect off of surfaces near the subject. Because it only affects darker colors, you can use specific colors without worrying about making the overall impression too shiny and bright. Glow Dodge, Add, and Add Glow all have a very similar effect that's best used for very bright sources of light, like the moon, or sun, or a glowing object. You can always lower the layer opacity if the light gets too intense. Tinting blend modes include Overlay, Soft Light, Hard Light, Vivid Light, Linear Light, and Pin Light. Overlay and Soft Light are great for adding just a touch of color to your drawing. They increase the contrast and lightly tint everything. Hard, Vivid, and Linear Light are good for more intense washes of color, like at sunset, for example. Functional blend modes include Hard Mix, Subtract, Difference, Divide, Exclusion, Hue, Color, Saturation, and Brightness. These ones are more advanced, but if you need something specific or you're fine-tuning an image, these are incredibly useful. When studying other people's art, sometimes I use Divide to see what shading colors they use for a particular base color. I simply select the base color I'd like to remove and use it as the blend color. The result left over is the extracted shading color that you can use on a multiply layer. Hue, saturation, color, and brightness are also good ways to do spot tonal correction. For example, I can decrease the brightness around her chin and neck, tweak the color of the flower, and increase the saturation of her eyes and skin. Once you know what each of them do, it's much easier to know which mode would give you the effect you want. Think of them like multi-purpose tools that you can use how you see fit. I hope that this video was helpful in understanding layer blend modes in your work, and thank you for watching!